the root. Yeah, I'm using for anytime I'm gonna do this like little flutter, whatever you wanna call it. I'm using my root note is gonna just be the lowest note of the chord. So for this, if you wanna see it real quick, it's A. F sharp minor is my sixth string, which is my root. To the D, four. To E, A. You can also certainly just play it like this. That you can pick the song out. To me, this is not this. This is one of the songs that, to me, it's there's a lot of different ways you can pick this song out, or you can strum this song. It's not like, you know, I don't know, certain tunes where it's a very distinct strumming pattern. To me, the thing I do feel is this, you know, this kind of doo-wop-y, that sort of technique. So if you can work,
the original does it that way.
What
version we know?
I'd have to listen back to it to determine that it was. I mean, in part, sometimes the way that I'll determine a strumming pattern in my own playing is out of necessity of being by yourself. And I'm saying, well, what does it sound like the drum's doing? You know what I mean? You know what I mean?
Kind of give it a little rhythm, then you can change your strumming.
You can, yeah. To me, I've talked about this before, but like strumming patterns to me is something that is useful until it's not useful anymore. Like, you really, you know, in a lot of ways, we don't want to be obsessing over a strumming pattern, but in the beginning, you got to get it, so you develop those rhythmic sensibilities. And then you can kind of throw it by the wayside and say, all right, I have a good understanding of when my up-down ratio needs to be. The problem with a lot of people when they're learning this is they're hitting on the upbeat in the wrong spot, or they're, you know what I mean? So that's why it's important to really get a good handle of it. And then you can carve it up however you want once you get a good feel for it. And it might take a couple years to get to that point. That's okay. You know what I mean? For now, so we can play through tonight, we can work a little bit more on that strumming pattern a little bit just by muting the strings. We can kind of talk about getting into that rhythm of, you know, bass, sweep up, up, down, up, bass, sweep up, up, down, up. We'll work on that a little bit more next time. Tonight, I'd say just pick something that feels comfortable for you. If it's comfortable for you to do down strums right now, that's cool. We're 5 minutes, so we gotta get through the song. So you can just survive through it and play it, you know what I mean?
John Lennon's version actually has a different strumming pattern, right?
Yeah, definitely. It's more definitely. And we should examine both. That'd be interesting to do a little just listening next week and listen to what is going on with both of those. Alright, ready?
Sorry, is this F sharp?
Oh yeah, F sharp minor. That's actually F sharp minor 7. Beautiful. If you put your pinky down, it's regular F sharp minor. You could play F sharp minor 7. This pinky's going to be under the, just like a power chord, the pinky's going to be on the,
oh,
yep, okay. Just like the power chord. See, now notice the relationship.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? The F sharp minor. So F sharp minor is going to be the second fret. Yeah, is everybody clear on their F sharp minor? And we've played it a couple times in this class, but yes, beautiful. You got it. Now, Josh, just move those down one. So, like, if you're going to play it like that, yeah, I'd recommend just doing the three and then your ring finger on the fourth. Yep, that's how I would do it. Everybody cool on that? All right, shall we try it?
Yeah.
Cool. One, two. One, two, three, A. It's going to be two times through per chord unless it's a split measure. F sharp minor. So now D, one time to the pattern, then the E, then back to A. When the night has gone, F sharp minor.
When it's dark
and the moon
is the only light you'll see.
A.
Afraid, oh, I won't be afraid.
was great, guys. That was awesome. That's killer. Beautiful. That was fun. So, right there, arpeggiating. All I'm doing is just taking the notes. I'm going literally A chord. F sharp minor. D. E. A. A lot of different ways to play the same chords up and down the neck. But that's just that shit. You know what I mean? It's not like I'm not adding any other notes, not even sevenths or anything. I'm just playing arpeggios of the chords.
Can you show me the F sharp major one?